I admit that in the past I've been a nasty. They weren't kidding when they called me, well, a witch. But you'll find that nowadays I've mended all my ways, repented, seen the light, and made a switch. True, yes. And I fortunately know a little magic. It's a talent that I always have possessed. And here lately, please don't laugh, I use it on behalf of the miserable, lonely, and depressed. Pathetic.
Hello guys, so today I'm going to be doing a really special video where I'm going to show you how I groom Sadie, you know, give her a bath and shed her down and all that. So yeah, don't make fun of my pants, that's all I gotta say. Bye. Hello guys, so the very first thing I do is I take this shedder tool and I shed down her first coat, you know, I just go like that and then up and down the steps. Sorry about all the grass and stuff. We have really bad weeds and stuff here, so. Yeah. It doesn't grow completely, no. It doesn't grow completely out of control because I usually try to do it really often, but she hates it. She hates bath. She hates it. Like, I try to train her not to like, you know, not to like be all bad with it, but, you know, yeah. She don't care. The reason why I did her butt area is because she has really long tufts back there, so I try to get everything and then I go like that, so if I leave any on the top layer of skin, it'll just fall off. This doesn't really mean anything when I do her face, it's just, you know, just in case she has a long hair that got swept up here, it gets off. And sometimes if like I'm going out to a place and I know there's gonna be food around, I'll trim up her, like her tail bits and her little tufts on the back of her butt, because those just, they fall out all the time, no matter if I just comb through them, they fall out. So if I know I'm going to be around food, I'll make sure that, you know, I know baby, that I'll cut those off, and they grow back really fast, so it's not like it's going to affect her any. I don't like to shave off her, her first coat, because I'm not sure how that would, you know, affect her and whatnot. But I'm going to look into it some more and see if that would be okay, because doing this... Okay, now that we're in the bathroom, I know this is such an awkward angle, but now that we're in the bathroom, what I usually do is get her wet, and I will use either this body wash stuff that is for my sister's husband, or I'll use our body wash, which me and my sister both use. So. It is hot, you know, like warmish water, so it's not like hurting her or anything. No baby. No baby. Thank you. She's a bigger dog, so, you know, it takes a couple of washings to get her exceptionally clean. You know, I wash, rinse, repeat kind of thing. Thank you. No, you're not done yet. I know, I don't like doing it either. Oh man, you got it everywhere. Now put towels over, I guess. And make sure you get all the soap off of them, of course. You know, you don't want them to have any skin infections or anything. No one wanted speckles. I know it looks kind of rough with me, you know, pushing around, but it's not, you know. I would never hurt her. For watching. I know it was really weird, awkward, and all that, but hopefully I'll get a real camera soon. So that is how I bathe and shed her. Bye. A little disclaimer here, guys. I know I was moving her around a lot, and I just watched through it, and it looks kind of rough, but it wasn't. I mean, I would never hurt her. I know I said that when she was in the bath, because I was moving her all around. It's just when she is taking a bath, she doesn't care much about obeying. She just doesn't like it. She's not comfortable with bathing, but you know, you have to. Not all dogs like baths. So I just want to say that no, I did not hurt her. No, you know, she wasn't uncomfortable or anything like that. It was just really directioning her to where I needed her. Just a little disclaimer there. I don't want anybody to think I hurt her or anything like that. So